ISUPK.
Yo, I thought with a bomb clock to them boy, man. Bad mind never kill them. Suffocate on a pussy wall. Yo, status. Tell some boys we don't chat us. Anyway, my dog go in on the street, them bad. Gun talking and we change member. If any somebody ever treat them bad, send the pussy them but meet them God. Louis V kick pan we feed them bad. Catch a new drip, dog we beat them bad. Look how we just come and we a beat them bad. You know sister we is them dad. Hey, but anyway though, this a no playground. The Glock 19, they have to stay round. Nah take no check with me payroll. Anything rise up, lay down. Them a send check but they won't. Dog we make it step if they don't. But at the same old, said them want smoke, but the grabber done flame out. A couple of y'all a come true.
Shalom Israel, we are the ISUPK out of 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commandant General Yohanna. And we are not affiliated with any religious group or organization. Today, what you are going to learn is not taught in your Christian churches. It is not taught in your mosques. It is not taught in your mandirs. It is not taught in your schools. It is not taught in your homes. Your grandmother never taught you this. Your mother never taught you this.
Good.
This is the truth about this Bible. We have been teaching that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. And we will approve this according to the Bible.
The book of Deuteronomy 28 and verse 1. And it shall come to pass.
The Bible says it shall come to pass. Go ahead.
If thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If thou shalt hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God. If thou shalt listen diligently. Go ahead.
To observe and do all his commandments.
To observe and apply all his commandments. Go ahead.
Which I command thee this day.
Go ahead.
That the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations on the earth.
That's right. Through Moses, the Most High was saying that if Israel at that time had listened to the laws, statutes, and commandments, they would be set high above all nations of the earth. And when we go through history and archaeology, today the Israelites in the Bible is the black man, the Hispanic man, and the Native Indian man. And if the black man is of the nation of Israel, and he's the black man today, which means that the Israelites of the Bible are the men in Jonjon.
Right.
Are the men in Sealot.
Right.
That's right.
Are the men in Beetham.
That's right.
Are the men in Point Fortin.
That's right.
Are the men in Labre.
That's right.
What your churches did not tell you is that the people in the ghetto are the lost, that are the chosen people of God.
Right. That's right.
They are the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
Right.
The Venezuelans coming across from Venezuela, they fall under the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
The Mexicans fall under the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
The Native Indians fall under the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
Your North American Indians fall under the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
That is what your churches and mosques and mandir and see a woman and mother Connox forgot to tell you.
Right.
We are the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. We are God's chosen people according to the Bible.
That's right.
Now we're going to see in Baruch chapter 4 that the conditions that we are in today was prophesied long ago. But we were supposed to keep the laws, statutes, and commandments in the Bible.
Right.
And our Christian leaders, our religious leaders failed us. They failed to mention that in the Bible, it had laws and statutes and commandments to keep. The laws would regulate our lives, how we should live day to day. The Bible had our culture.
Right.
The Bible had our economic system.
Right.
The Bible had our military system.
Right.
The Bible had the way a nation is supposed to be set up.
Right.
And what they failed to tell you is that the Bible was not for everybody.
Right.
According to this Bible, the Bible is a black man's book.
That's
the
right.
Bible is black history.
That's right.
And because of slavery at colonial times, they make us to feel that the Bible is a white man's book. But how can the Bible be a white man's book when the angels are black? The prophets are black.
That's right.
Christ is black.
Right. That's right.
Everything in the Bible is black.
That's right. Right.
Give up chapter 4 and verse 1.
The book of Ruth, chapter 4 and verse 1. This is the book of the commandments of God and the laws that dwell forever.
That's right. The scripture is saying, this is the book of the commandments and laws of the Lord. This is what he said down for the black man to live by. Go ahead.
All they that keep it shall come to life.
It says all they that keep it shall come to life. We will escape the oppressions of this society.
Right.
We will escape injustice.
Right.
AR-45s, nines, and semi-automatic is not justice.
Right.
The Lord said he will inflict justice.
Right. Right. But such as leave it, it shall die.
And it said that such as leave the laws of this book shall die. How will we die? We'll be shot in the streets. We'll be lowered down in society.
Right.
We will be wanting all things from the other nation.
Right.
We will be broken to nothing. We will not know our heritage, our culture. That is how we will die.
Right. The book of Baruch, chapter 4 and verse 6.
Go ahead.
You were sold to the nations, not for your destruction.
That's right. The Mosa is saying, we were sold to our enemies, not for our destruction.
Right.
We all know the history of the Atlantic slave trade, when the white man sold the black man into slavery.
Right.
And the ships used to transport us here into the new Americas or into the Caribbean was built by the Arabs.
Right.
But your pastor wouldn't tell you that. Your pastor wouldn't tell you that Spain conquered the native Indians and shipped them into Europe back into slavery.
Right.
The black man was in slavery, the native Indian man was in slavery, the Hispanic man was in slavery.
Right.
And your pastor wouldn't tell you that the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man is one nation.
Right.
That's why all where you go, the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man lie in the ghettos.
Right.
We lie in the slums.
Right.
We lie in the places of desolation.
Right.
But there is something coming. The Most High is coming to deliver his people.
Right.
Go ahead, continue.
But because you move the Most High to wrath.
It says, because we move the Most High to wrath, we are in this condition today. That's why we are being shut down all over the place. And we are constantly under oppression year after year. Go ahead.
You were delivered unto the enemies. Verse 7. For you provoked him that made you by sacrificing unto devils.
That's right. We provoked the Most High by sacrificing unto devils.
Right.
And idols. How did we do that? By going to the Christian church.
Right.
They deceive us. They take all our monies.
Right.
They stack it up in houses, in their walls, in their coffers, having fat bank accounts while you black man is on the street.
Right.
While you black man is forced to rob a store with an AK or AR-45. That is the life of the black man today. But vengeance is coming for these under nations.
Right.
Now we're gonna understand what the black man, Hispanic man, and native Indian man life is supposed to be on the face of this earth.
Right.
We're gonna understand that if we had kept the laws, statutes, and commandments from way back, from generations ago, that we would not be in these conditions. That is why we need to dust off that Bible you have on the shelf. Go in and take a look at these scriptures. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 9. And thou shalt brook at the noonday. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 9.
Go ahead.
And the Lord shall establish thee and holy people unto himself.
The scripture is saying, the Lord shall establish Israel as a holy people unto himself. And if history and archaeology is saying that the Israelites of the Bible is the black man, Hispanic man, and native Indian man, go ahead.
as he had sworn unto thee.
And he will establish us as a holy people, separate unto himself, go ahead.
If thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy power and walk in his ways.
That's right. But we had to keep the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God.
Right.
And when you look at all our religious institutions today, they tell us one thing in common. We can all do what we want, and we have no laws to keep. You can eat what you want. You can sleep with who you want. If you feel to sleep with a dog, sleep with a dog.
Right.
If you feel to marry a man, marry a man. That is what the Christian church has become today.
Right.
And they're telling you that if you are a member of these institutions, then you have to accept it. But according to the Bible, the Most High God laid down laws for man. Man was never supposed to sleep with man.
Right.
Man was never supposed to sleep with beasts.
Right.
Man was never supposed to commit adultery.
That's right.
There are laws founded in his Bible, and the Lord said that it would go on to generations upon generation upon generation. It was never supposed to stop.
Right.
Verse 10, and all the people of the earth shall see thee, see that thou art called by the name of the Most High.
That's right. When the black man, the Hispanic man, and the native Indian man start to walk in the ways of the Most High, when he starts to build his economic system, when he starts to keep his culture, when he starts to keep his laws, that's why the other nations will know we are wise people. Go ahead.
And they shall be afraid of thee.
And they shall be what?
They shall be afraid of thee.
That's right. What your Christian pastor wouldn't tell you is that when the black man, the Hispanic man, and the native Indian man keep these laws, the nations become afraid of us. That's right. That is the black man's might in this Bible. That is why we have to understand, black man, we need to keep these laws. We need to come out of these Christian churches. They have been deceiving us for years.
What?
Look up the history of the Christian church. See where it goes back to. The Baptist church goes back to a white man. The church of the Latter-day Saints goes back to a white man.
Right.
The Open Bible Church goes back to a white man.
Right.
The Roman Catholic Church goes back to a white man.
Right.
These religious institutions keep chasing back to the colonial slave master.
That's right.
And we need to come out and separate from this if we are truly want to unite as one. Go ahead.
The book of 2 Ezra chapter 5 and verse 23.
Go ahead.
And said, O Lord, that beareth and rule.
That's right. The Most High God that beareth and rule over this world. Go ahead.
Of every wood of the earth and of all the trees thereof, thou hast chosen thee one only vine.
That's right. Of all the trees of the earth, the Most High has chosen one. Which means he has a favorite. Right. And his favorite is the vine, the grapes. That is his favorite, go ahead.
Verse 24. And of all the land of the whole world, thou hast chosen thee one bit.
That's right. Of all the lands of the world, the Most High has a favorite spot on the earth. Your Christian pastor wouldn't tell you that, go ahead.
And of all the flowers thereof, one lily.
So of all the land, he has one favorite place on the earth, which is Jerusalem. And of all the flowers, he has a favorite flower, which is the lily. Go ahead.
Verse 25. And of all the depths of the sea, thou hast filled thee one river.
That's right. Of all the seas, the Most High has a favorite river. Go ahead.
And of all builded cities, thou hast hollowed Zion unto thyself.
And of all the famous cities, the Lord has hollowed Zion unto himself.
Good.
He has made Jerusalem that special place.
Good.
The land of Israel.
Good.
Jerusalem is the capital of Israel.
Good.
That is the Most High land upon the face of the earth.
Good.
It was separate for the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man.
Good.
Go ahead.
Verse 26. And of all the foes that are created, thou hast named it thee one dove.
That's right. Of all the birds of the air, your Christian pastor wouldn't tell you this. Of all the birds of the air, the Most High had a favorite bird, and it was the dove. What?
And unto this people whom thou lovest, thou hast given a law that is above all.
That's right. And what your Christian pastor and all these religious institutions wouldn't tell you that the Most High had a favorite people.
Good.
I didn't say that. The Bible is saying that.
Good.
The Most High had a favorite people.
Good. That's right.
And that people was the nation of Israel.
Good.
Which is the black man, the Hispanic man, and the native Indian man.
Good. That's right.
We are the chosen people of God.
That's right.
And right now, we are in the ghettos. We are in the slums. We are under the oppression of white supremacy.
Good.
But the Most High said, he is coming back to deliver us from this oppression.
Good.
Vengeance is not ours, but our part is coming back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of this Bible.
Good.
We are the ISUPK out of 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commandant General Yohana, and we are not affiliated with any religious group or organization.
In the street, them bad. Gun talking and we change member. If any somebody ever treat them bad, send the pussy them but meet them God. Louis me kicks upon we feed them bad. Catch a new drip, dog me beat them bad. Look how we just come and we a beat them bad. You know sister we is them dad. Hey, but anyway though, this a no playground. The Glock 19, they have to stay round. Nah, take no check with me payroll. Anything rise up, play down. Them a send check, but they won't. Dog, we will make it step if they don't. But at the same old, said them want smoke, but the grab a done flame out. A couple y'all a come through. Y'all a WhatsApp, what she gonna come through? She a give me tap and she swallow some juice. Y'all a suck cock till me Jonathan blow. Bentley van a come through. Converted the drop top, still have a sunroof. The dog them rolls chop your one proof. Alright, wanna move, wanna move. Anyway, my dogs go in the street, them bad. Gun talking and we change member. If any somebody ever treat them bad, send the pussy them for me.